In this lecture, we will study how arrays are stored and how arrays are accessed. We have already used arrays, character strings and all that, but there are certain other details about arrays which we need to understand, and we will understand them through several programs, and using these programs we will be able to see what they mean. Till now we already know that you can declare an array, an integer array, say A, like this. A one dimensional array A can be declared like this. A is the array name and 50 elements are there of type, each of type one integer. Okay. So 50 elements each of type one integer is stored in this array A. Now let us try and understand the meaning of certain things. When you write int A 50, it means that AI, the content, that is AI is of type integer. The content of AI is an integer. Please understand this very carefully. The content of AI, the content of A0 to A49 are all integers. Okay? A, this A, is the array name and can be used in various capacities. This is the address of so A, the value of A is an address and it is equivalent to this address. This is the first point. The second point is that the array is stored in contiguous locations in the memory. If this is A0, which is also the value of the address A, that is you can access this A as an address, then the next will be A1, but they are not one after another, because if this requires 4 bytes of memory, then this is after 4 places this will start in the memory. So A1, address of A1 will be address of A0 plus the size of an integer. There is a size of function which you can have a look at and find out sizes of various predeclared types. So this is plus 1 and so on. So one dimensional array is stored in contiguous locations like this. In C, these addresses have values and these addresses are also known by a very popular term called they are pointers to locations. Addresses of locations are also called pointers to locations. So A is a pointer to the start of the array and A1 is the pointer to the location A1. That is how we refer to it in terms of C language. Second point, let us come to a two-dimensional array. A two-dimensional array, say written like this, it means that the content of any AI, I between 0 to 19, the content of any AIJ I between 0 and 19 and j between 0 and 21 is an integer. All right? Now see this int b 30. B, there is a pattern in this whole definition. B is the address of the start of this array. Similarly, A is the address of the start of the two-dimensional array. So A is the same as and A0, and A5, suppose I say A5, what do I mean by A5? A5 means this is this part of the array, A5. For example, this part B is the starting location of the array B, which is the address of B0. A5 will be the starting location, will be equivalent to and A5, 0. It will be the starting location of the array starting with A. So, conceptually, 0 to 19, and then you can address it like this. This is one way of looking at it. A 0 0, A 0 1, so on. A 1 0 and so on. A 19 0 and so on. This is one point, that is A5 is the address. Since the content is this, part of it will give you the address. This will give you a two AI will give you a one dimensional array, but each array, each element of that one dimensional array is an array, is another one dimensional array. That is the idea. Each element of this one dimensional array is a one-dimensional array. A is an array, and each element of that array, A is an address which considers such that each element of this block is a two-dimensional array. A is a pointer to a two-dimensional array. This is a pointer to a one-dimensional array, and this gives you the final location. All right. So, this is, so you can conceptually have a look at it this in this way. These are the addresses of one dimensional arrays. The second point is how they are stored in the memory. Suppose you declare int A 5 6, then they are stored in the memory this way. The contiguous storage in the memory is A00 followed by A01, A02, A04, then A10. This is how they are stored in the contiguous locations of the memory. We will run programs to just check out, you know, you can just print out addresses and you can just check what the exact values are. So, it will not be difficult to see what they mean. So, this is the sequence of contiguous locations, and if you declare then this is a three dimension array. And if you write down A 5 1 2, then it will give you the value of the location 5 1 2. If you write A 5 1, it will give you the address of the array of two elements which starts at 5 1. So you can look at it as a multidimensional structure. And if you write down A5, it will give you the address of the 1 by 2 array from the fifth place. So you look at it as a cube, and if you look at it as a cube, then you will see, then inside this cube you have got subcubes. This three-dimensional array is of 5 elements. Each element is a two-dimensional array like this. And there are 5, suppose this was say 2. There are 10 such blocks, of which each of them 0, 0, 0, 1 up to 5, 2, each of them is a one-dimensional array. And there are 20 such blocks where each of them is an integer. That is the way you have to look at the array structure. This will give you several ideas about what how to declare arrays, how to call arrays, because they can be accessed in various ways. Secondly, there is a content and the address location. Int A10. Suppose I declared this. Then A is the same as and A0. A plus 1 is the same as and A1. Content of A plus 1 is the same as A1. The content of the location and A1 star of and of A1 is A1. So, star of A plus 1 is A1. Content of A plus 1 is A1. So, this way A plus I content is the same as the value of AI. So, you can use this also to access an array. Coming to two-dimensional arrays. A is the same as and A. A plus 1. What is A? What is A plus 1? That is the first question. What is A plus 1? What is the content of A plus 1? The content of A plus 1 is A1. This is the same. If it was a one dimensional array, A plus 1 would have been and A1. Here also it is and A1. This is very streamlined. A plus 1 is the same as and A1. Content of A plus 1 is A1, but since it is a two-dimensional array, this is equivalent to right. This is the starting location. A1 is the starting location of an array of 4 elements. This one, look at it conceptually like this. This is the array A0, A1, A2, A3, A4. And then each of them bifurcates into the two-dimensional array. So, this is A, this is A11, and if you have a three-dimensional array, then each of them will again go out and make arrays. And if you do not understand this structure carefully, you will not appreciate the address and the content configurations in C. So, this structure must be understood very clearly and carefully. So, what is star A plus 1 plus 3? start, it is the address of the location A 1 3, and star of that will give you the value of the actual location, the value, because now your this ends up in a slot which is an integer. That is how it has been defined. This is the address of the two-dimensional array, this is the address of the one-dimensional array, each element composing of an array, and this is the address where each element consists of a slot. So this way you can do addressing and get the contents of variables. There are other declarations of addresses or pointers which we shall see later on when we see dynamic allocation, except in arrays where you don't have to give the array dimension. For example, in a function f where a is an array and n is an integer, we used to declare int a n. You don't have to give the dimension because you don't have to allocate elements. Here also you can also do f a n int star a n, which means that the content of a is an integer. And then you can a plus 1, you will get the address of that location. But in such a situation, only one pointer element will be allocated as a variable. And you can move this pointer along this array because you have just passed the array name, but you have not allocated the array values. This will come as it comes through parameter passing. But in the main program, if you want to declare an array, say int a 50, and instead of that you declare int star a, then it will not automatically work, because here you have allocated 50 elements. Here you have only allocated a pointer to the array. In order to allocate another 50 elements during execution of the program, you have to do something else. You have to do dynamic allocation, which we shall come to later on. For the time being, we are not bothered about dynamic allocation. We are just trying to see what arrays and structures mean. Arrays and pointers and contents of arrays mean. So we will go through a set of 5 examples which will show us how they can be used in a variety of ways. This is a bubble sorting or exchange sorting program. So in this exchange sorting program, we read in a set of elements, we do sorting by exchange sort, and we try to introduce various concepts of addresses. The first one, we declare integer data 100 I, j and temp, read the value of n, print the value of n, and then read the data. Now here normally we used to give and data I, but here we can also give data plus I, which is the same as and data I. And instead of printing data I, we can print it by star of data plus I. So you can just read and print, you will get the values. And sorting. This is a simple sorting routine for I equal to 0 till I is less than n minus 1, j equal to I plus 1, j less than n. If data I is less than data j, here again instead of data I you can write star of data plus I. On the left side also you can write star of data plus I. But on the left side you cannot assign data plus I equal to 5, that you cannot do. You cannot change the array address. Suddenly if you want to change the address of the array is allocated by the machine. And if you want to change the array address, you cannot do that. Unless you declare a variable of pointer type, you can change that variable. All variables that you declare, for example, here, the content of the variables I can change. I cannot change the addresses of the variables because the addresses are allocated by the machine. Therefore, here start data plus I equal to data j and data j equal to temp. Okay? And again, we can print them here. You print data I, you can print star of data plus I. So, you can use them in such a variety of ways and it will work quite fine. Coming to the second example, here we use a function. And this function is called sort array. Here again we have read data plus I, initially printed star of data plus I and called sort r data n. And after sorting we printed the sorted. Now in the sorting, as we did before, int arr this, we do not have to give the value because we do not allocate any element, we only want the address. Though we cannot change this address, we will utilize this address. And we can similarly use the star of arr plus I, we can use the content and access it by the array. We can access it both ways, see, we can access it as an array like this or we can access it like this. Both accesses are allowed. This way the same thing can be done. Let us see the third example. In the third example is identical to the second example except this declaration. Here we declared only a pointer because that is all we need, we do not need to allocate elements. In the previous case also we did not declare anything, we did not allocate anything, we just allocated the, we just declared that the array address is a pointer to an integer. That is the content of arr which is equivalent to the start address of the array. What is this? This is and arr 0 and what did we say? Arr, the content of arr is an integer. So, the content of arr and arr 0 is an integer, which is quite okay and we use it identically and it will again cause no problems. So, this is another way. This is called pointer to an integer. So, this is fine. Now, we will see given an array declaration, how, what are the array indices, how are they allocated? Can we print out their addresses and see how they are allocated? So, we declared a simple array of 10 elements 0 to 9 and we print A, that is we print the address, and to print the address there is a percentage P, that is type pointer. This is type pointer, it will give you, sorry, it will give you the value in hexadecimal format, and if you want it in its integer format then you have to print it in its unsigned. So, it is declared as an unsigned integer. A pointer is an unsigned integer, it cannot take negative values, it can take only positive values, that is why it is an unsigned integer. So, percentage U is unsigned integer. So, first we printed A, then we printed A plus 1, then we printed A plus 2, then we assigned A2 to 6 and we printed star of A plus 2 and A2 just to see, and you will also be able to see from the difference between A and A plus 1 and A plus 1 and A plus 2 what is the number of bytes allocated for an integer. Okay. So, A, the system allocated it to the location 7B033258, which is the hexadecimal value. Its equivalent decimal value is the location 20638070.64. A1 is to, I have just printed the unsigned integer value here, 20638070.68. So, 4 places, 4 bytes are stored for an integer. This is 72 and then the content of A plus 2 is 6, which we assigned. Interestingly, nobody will disturb you if you write down something like this. Possibly, let's check. There is nothing wrong in writing this down, because you are just writing down A is a value, you are adding it, it is an arithmetic expression, so you will get the value. There is nothing wrong in this, but the question is, if we do this, what will happen? Do you know what will happen? This is what will happen. So, you have to be very careful about how you write a program. It will access that location, and just unless it is a location protected by the system, unless it is a system location, that is, it is a location where the OS is there or protected, it will simply go and write it. This is not Pascal, which will check your value out of range and array out of range and all that. In C, nobody tells you what will happen. So, please be very sure and very careful about what will happen, because here this is computed, this address is computed, and you are just saying this content of this address is equal to 6, it will be made 6. There is no automatic check, but there are some other software through which if you run it, you will be able to find out whether it does it. So, now let us see the last example for a two-dimensional array. Please pay attention. Suppose we have a two-dimensional array A. Suppose we have a two-dimensional array A. 5, 10. As we discussed, there are 0 to 5, A0 to A5 is an array where each element is a one dimensional array of 10 integers. That is how we can look at it. So, A, this is the address A, A plus 1, A plus 2, content of A plus 2 will be the same as A2. Content of A plus 2 plus 3 will be the same as and A23. A will be the same as and A00, which will be the same as and A0. All of them will be same. And A0 is the same as and A00 is the same as A. A23 is the same as we were doing a bit earlier. Content of the content of A plus 2 plus 3. Now let us see. This is 20380732, which is the start of the array. A plus 1, the difference is how many bytes? 40 bytes. You remember we declared it. So A plus 1 will give you the address of AND A 1 0. Similarly, A plus 2 another 40 bytes. Content of A plus 2, which is the same as A plus 2, because A plus 2 is AND A 2 0. Content of A plus 2 is A 2, which is the same as AND A 2 0. So both will be, all these three will be identical. Alright. Now this one will be content of A plus 2, then plus 3, which will give you the location of the address and A 2 3, which will be 12 bytes after this. 4 into 3, 12 bytes. So you have got 12 bytes after this. And then A 2 3 equal to 6 is fine. You can get the value of the location. Similarly, you have to extend your ideas to 3 dimensions, 4 dimensions. But there is a pattern and a structure in the whole thing. So it should not be difficult for you to understand how to declare and use arrays. What even part of an array means something. Part of an array is not an undefined quantity. Suppose you define a 10 dimensional array and you write only 5 of the dimensions, then it also means something. So that is what has to be taken care of and what can be utilized during programming. So we will terminate with this discussion, but we will remember two or three things. One is, in the main program, int A50 and int star A are not identical. They are identical in the sense that this is an address to an array and this can be used as an address to an array, but this does allocate 50 elements and this allocates only a pointer variable. This is a pointer variable. This variable can be changed. You can use this value and start changing it. Okay. But here this array A cannot be changed. This is the address of the array which the system will allocate. Here this can be changed. And then if you want to allocate 50, 30, 40, 60 elements, then you will have to do dynamic allocation. And we will come to dynamic allocation a bit later on. But before that, we will move on to structures. So next day we will study structures and see.